Hi, I'm Chris McNulty, Senior Product Manager on the Office 365 team here at Microsoft. When working with content as part of SharePoint, it's important to be able to standardize and reinvent business processes. That's why we've integrated Microsoft Flow to help deal with some common scenarios, like requesting sign-off on new documents or bringing data in from third-party systems. Let's take a look. With Flow, Office 365 opens new ways to integrate standardized patterns and procedures into any document-centric process. Some of these are now built automatically for everyone across Office 365. Right now, I'm going to take a look at our new request sign-off process. By using this, I can automatically send a document to a colleague for approval with a short comment. Let's take a look. So I'm choosing my colleague, Dan Kogan, and add a short message. I think we're ready. And run the flow. Once this processes, Dan will receive a message with a link to the document asking him to take a look. Let's review it from his perspective. Now we're inside Dan's email. We can see Dan's received a message with my message and a link to the document, as well as buttons allowing him to approve or reject this directly from inside of his email. And the flow returns control of the document back to me inside of the document library. Dan could also use the Flow Approval Center to see the full history of documents submitted to him for sign-off previously, as well as any requests he may have sent and pending requests still looking for his approval or denial. We also offer the Flow mobile application to accomplish the same result. Now I'm back inside of my email, and you can see, with my process, I've received notification that Dan Kogan has signed off on my item along with his notes and a convenient link back to the document. Plus, in addition to being alerted via email, I can always check the status of any documents currently pending sign-off from the document library. We add a custom metadata column directly to the library so I can see what's pending, what's been declined, and what's been approved. With Microsoft Flow, I can integrate hundreds of business data sources with predefined triggers and actions to allow me to automate a multitude of business processes. Many of these flows are integrated into templates, which are filtered by my current activities. What this means is, inside the document library, I can use the Flow command on the toolbar to create a new process. SharePoint will show me some of the most likely templates that I might want to use that connect to or from SharePoint, including integration with Adobe, OneDrive, Teams, and other sources. Opening up even more templates will bring me into the Flow Designer, where I can choose from dozens of integrations that have already been built for me. Many of these templates cover common productivity scenarios, such as task management, event setup, or file movement. And I can build more using connectors. Here, I'm looking at some of the hundreds of connectors available through Office 365. I've already set up a flow to integrate with a third-party blogging service. This flow is triggered anytime a new post is made on our outside travel blog. It captures the key details into my marketing team. Once the document lands there, as before, I can use request sign-off to route this to a member of my team for approval and further analysis.